Bipedalism is a form of terrestrial locomotion where an organism moves by means of its two rear limbs or legs. An animal or machine that usually moves in a bipedal manner is known as a biped, biped, meaning 2 feet. Types of bipedal movement include walking, running, or hopping. Few modern species are habitual bipeds whose normal method of locomotion is two-legged. Within mammals, habitual bipedalism has evolved multiple times, with the macropods, kangaroo rats and mice, spring hare, hopping mice, pangolins and hominin and apes, as well as various other extinct groups evolving the trait independently. In the Triassic period, some groups of archosaurs developed bipedalism, among their descendants, the dinosaurs. All the early forms and many later groups were habitual or exclusive bipeds. The birds descended from one group of exclusively bipedal dinosaurs. A larger number of modern species intermittently or briefly use a bipedal gait. Several non-archosaurian lizard species move bipedally when running, usually to escape from threats. Many primate and bear species will adopt a bipedal gait in order to reach food or explore their environment. Several arboreal primate species, such as gibbons and indriads, exclusively walk on two legs during the brief period they spend on the ground. Many animals rear up on their hind legs whilst fighting or copulating. A few animals commonly stand on their hind legs, in order to reach food, to keep watch, to threaten a competitor or predator, or to pose in courtship, but do not move bipedally. Definition. The word is derived from the Latin words by two and ped, foot, as contrasted with quadruped, 4 feet. Advantages: limited and exclusive bipedalism can offer a species several advantages. Bipedalism raises the head. This allows a greater field of vision with improved detection of distant dangers or resources. Access to deeper water for wading animals and allows the animals to reach higher food sources with their mouths. While upright, non-locomotory limbs become free for other uses, including manipulation, flight, digging, combat or camouflage. The maximum bipedal speed appears less fast than the maximum speed of quadrupedal movement with a flexible backbone. Both the ostrich and the red kangaroo can reach speeds of 70 km per hour, while the cheetah can exceed 100 km per hour. Bipedality in kangaroo rats has been hypothesized to improve locomotor performance, which could aid in escaping from predators. Facultative and obligate bipedalism. Zoologists often label behaviors, including bipedalism, as facultative or obligate. Even this distinction is not completely clear-cut. For example, humans normally walk and run in biped fashion, but almost all can crawl on hands and knees when necessary. There are even reports of humans who normally walk on all fours with their feet but not their knees on the ground. But these cases are a result of conditions such as Unna-Tan syndrome, very rare genetic neurological disorders rather than normal behavior. Even if one ignores exceptions caused by some kind of injury or illness, there are many unclear cases, including the fact that normal humans can crawl on hands and knees. This article therefore avoids the terms facultative and obligate, and focuses on the range of styles of locomotion normally used by various groups of animals. Movement. There are a number of states of movement commonly associated with bipedalism. Standing. Staying still on both legs. In most bipeds, this is an active process, requiring constant adjustment of balance. Walking, one foot in front of another, with at least one foot on the ground at any time. Running, one foot in front of another, with periods where both feet are off the ground. Jumping, hopping, moving by a series of jumps with both feet moving together. Bipedal animals. The great majority of living terrestrial vertebrates are quadrupeds, with bipedalism exhibited by only a handful of living groups. Humans, gibbons and large birds walk by raising one foot at a time. On the other hand, most macropods, smaller birds, lemurs and bipedal rodents move by hopping on both legs simultaneously. Tree kangaroos are able to walk or hop. most commonly alternating feet when moving arboreally and hopping on both feet simultaneously when on the ground. Amphibians. There are no known living or fossil bipedal amphibians. Extant reptiles. Many species of lizards become bipedal during high-speed sprint locomotion, including the world's fastest lizard, the spiny-tailed iguana. Early reptiles and lizards. The first known biped is the Bolosaurid Eudobarmus, whose fossils date from 290 million years ago. Its long hind legs, short forelegs, and distinctive joints all suggest bipedalism. The species was extinct before the dinosaurs appeared. Archosaurs. Birds. All birds are bipeds when on the ground, a feature inherited from their dinosaur ancestors. Other archosaurs. Bipedalism evolved more than once in archosaurs, the group that includes both dinosaurs and crocodilians. All dinosaurs are thought to be descended from a fully bipedal ancestor, perhaps similar to Eoraptor. Bipedal movement also re-evolved in a number of other dinosaur lineages, such as the iguanodons. Some extinct members of the crocodilian line, a sister group to the dinosaurs and birds, also evolved bipedal forms. A crocodile relative from the Triassic, Ephigia okeifer, is thought to be bipedal. Pterosaurs were previously thought to have been bipedal, but recent trackways have all shown quadrupedal locomotion. Bipedalism also evolved independently among the dinosaurs. Dinosaurs diverged from their archosaur ancestors approximately 230 million years ago during the Middle to Late Triassic period, roughly 20 million years after the Permian-Triassic extinction event wiped out an estimated 95% of all life on Earth. Radiometric dating of fossils from the early dinosaur genus Eoraptor establishes its presence in the fossil record at this time. Paleontologists suspect Eoraptor resembles the common ancestor of all dinosaurs. If this is true, its traits suggest that the first dinosaurs were small, bipedal predators. The discovery of primitive dinosaur-like ornithoderants such as Marsupilus and Lagopitan in Argentinian Middle Triassic strata supports this view. Analysis of recovered fossils suggests that these animals were indeed small, bipedal predators. Mammals. A number of groups of extant mammals have independently evolved bipedalism as their main form of locomotion, for example humans. Giant pangolins, the extinct giant ground sloths, numerous species of jumping rodents and macropods. Humans. As their bipedalism has been extensively studied, are documented in the next section. Macropods are believed to have evolved bipedal hopping only once in their evolution, at some time no later than 45 million years ago. Bipedal movement is less common among mammals, most of which are quadrupedal. All primates possess some bipedal ability, though most species primarily use quadrupedal locomotion on land. Primates aside, the macropods, kangaroo rats and mice, hopping mice and spring hare move bipedally by hopping. Very few mammals other than primates commonly move bipedally by an alternating gait rather than hopping. Exceptions are the ground pangolin and in some circumstances the tree kangaroo. Primates. Most bipedal animals move with their backs close to horizontal, using a long tail to balance the weight of their bodies. The primate version of bipedalism is unusual because the back is close to upright. Many primates can stand upright on their hind legs without any support. Chimpanzees, bonobos, gibbons and baboons exhibit forms of bipedalism. Injured chimpanzees and bonobos have been capable of sustained bipedalism. Gelidae, although often quadrupedal, will move between adjacent feeding patches with a squatting, shuffling bipedal form of locomotion. Three captive primates, one macaque Natasha and two chimps, Oliver and Poco, were found to move bipedally. Natasha switched to exclusive bipedalism after an illness, while Poco was discovered in captivity in a tall, narrow cage. Oliver reverted to knuckle walking after developing arthritis. In addition, non-human primates often use bipedal locomotion when carrying food. One hypothesis for human bipedalism is thus that it evolved as a result of differentially successful survival from carrying food to share with group members. Although there are other hypotheses, as discussed below, limited bipedalism in mammals. Other mammals engage in limited, non-locomotory, bipedalism. A number of other animals, such as rats, raccoons, and beavers, will squat on their hind legs to manipulate some objects but revert to four limbs when moving. Bears will fight in a bipedal stance to use their four legs as weapons. A number of mammals will adopt a bipedal stance in specific situations, such as for feeding or fighting. Ground squirrels and meerkats will stand on hind legs to survey their surroundings, but will not walk bipedally. Dogs can stand or move on two legs if trained, or if birth defect or injury precludes quadrupedalism. The Gerenu cantaloupe stands on its hind legs while eating from trees, as did the extinct giant ground sloth and Chalico theirs. The spotted skunk will walk on its front legs when threatened, rearing up on its front legs while facing the attacker so that its anal glands, capable of spraying an offensive oil, face its attacker. Limited bipedalism in non-mammals. Bipedalism is unknown among the amphibians. Among the non-archosaur reptiles, bipedalism is rare, but it is found in the reared-up running of lizards such as agamids and monitor lizards. Many reptile species will also temporarily adopt bipedalism while fighting. One genus of basilisk lizard can run bipedally across the surface of water for some distance. Among arthropods, cockroaches are known to move bipedally at high speeds. Bipedalism is rarely found outside terrestrial animals, though at least two types of octopus walk bipedally on the seafloor using two of their arms, allowing the remaining arms to be used to camouflage the octopus as a mat of algae or a floating coconut.